Hello, I'm Sebastian de Vet, and I'm from the Earth Surface Science Group of the University of Amsterdam. And I'm very curious what happens with processes such as convection. And we find a lot of those examples here on Earth. So if you look at the globe, we can find them in the ocean, but at the same time also in the atmosphere above it. And I'm quite curious what happens in space with these processes. So a lot of these processes of convection take place here on Earth thanks to gravity. And with the planet, we have quite a lot of it. What would happen if we would switch off gravity? And that's what André Kuipers is studying for us. And together with my colleague Jacques van Loon, we proposed a very simple experiment that allows us to test whether this process works in space as well. And you can carry it out together with André in your classroom.
Hello, guten Tag, bonjour, buenos dias. I'm here in the International Space Station and I float and everything floats. And that means that we have a fantastic opportunity to do research. And that's what we're doing here in the International Space Station. We do research on the effects of weightlessness. The effect that we don't really feel the gravity effects here. Now, therefore, we have a lot of experiments going on here. We have experiments with fluids, we have experiments with flames, we have experiments with our vestibular organ. So we do all kinds of experiments to investigate what the effect of weight is on this phenomena that we're looking at. Now, this is also what we're going to do now. This experiment, EPO convection, is also an experiment to see what the effect of weightlessness is. And therefore, for a real experiment, you need a control experiment on ground. And that's what you are all doing on ground. And you need an idea, an hypothesis. What will be the outcome? For example, for this one, will there be more flow like you see on Earth? Will there be less flow? Or will there be no results at all? Or that's also a result, no effect at all. So, we have to do this experiment now. And because of that, well, it doesn't matter how I hold it here on Earth. It's important to keep it in a certain way, but here I can hold it in any way. There's no up and down. So I'll demonstrate to you this experiment now in weightless conditions. And we need a good background, and I come a bit closer to you. My hand is just as warm as it was on Earth, and I'm transferring the same amount of heat into the water. And the water in the convection loop is therefore becoming less dense. However, despite the fact that heated water on Earth and in space both become less dense, the outcome is definitely not the same. It seems from this experiment that gravity is necessary to observe the flow of convection, because gravity, or weight, is the only difference between the experiment here on the ISS and yours on Earth. As you could see, no real effect. Nothing moved. So, this is the result of our experiment here in space. And I would like to know if your hypothesis was correct. Did you have the right idea? So, what is happening? Well, if you heat something up, a fluid, then under my hand, the molecules get more energy. They start to move more, they vibrate more, they need more space, they push each other off. That means that they get less dense. Less dense means less mass. Means if the gravity is there, if it pulls on it, there is a difference between the warm liquid and cold liquid. So warm liquid goes up. You can feel it if you swim, for example. If you go deeper in the water, it becomes colder. And higher on the surface, it's warmer. And in space, that doesn't happen. So warm fluids do not go up because there is no up, there is no down. So that's the big difference. So we have seen that convection doesn't work in microgravity. So if we want to move a fluid, we have to put force in it. I can move this fluid, not by heat as we have seen, but by mechanical force. So for example, let's spin it. Whoa! So by spinning it, you can move the liquid inside. But that's a mechanical force, it's not convection. You can try it on Earth as well. So with mechanical force, like this, and be careful that it doesn't flow off, because then it breaks. So with mechanical force like this, you can move the fluid. On Earth, we see a lot of convection as well. We see it in the oceans, which takes many, many years, the convection streams. It takes only a few minutes here, but in the oceans, a lot of time. We see it in the atmosphere, when hot air is going up. We see it when a balloon flies. The hot air balloon has less dense air in it, so that goes upwards. So there's a lot of places. And, well, we have a look out of the cupola, so we can see there as well what it means, how the Earth looks like, and you can see evidences of convection there. As part of the ESA mission, the PromISSe mission, we have an educational program called Spaceship Earth. And with Spaceship Earth, we're going to demonstrate several things, and one of them is, for example, convection on Earth. And I'm here now in the cupola, and the cupola is a fantastic place where we can see the Earth 360 degrees around. So I'm going to show you some interesting views of our planet, and also some aspects of convection. It's very clear that convection is happening all over Earth, in the atmosphere, the water, and even inside the Earth. Gravity, that's the force that affects the direction of the flow, is one thing that allows this convection to take place. All these convection processes that I can see here from space are similar to the small experiment that you can carry out yourself. From space you see a lot of different cloud patterns, and clouds are a nice example of convection. So it's the warmer air that goes up, and then it comes to the cold layers, and the water condensates and forms the clouds. So without convection we wouldn't see all this. And there's a lot of different shapes here in the clouds, and it's very beautiful to see. And here we fly over the Alps and you see a lot of snow. And the convection also means different kinds of temperatures on different kinds of altitudes, and it creates a big difference in plant life and wildlife. The Alps are beautiful, lots of snow. Now here we can see the island of Sicily under the clouds, and on there we have the volcano Etna, which is actually active at the moment. And volcanism is also one of the demonstrations that we have of convection on Earth. Because of the liquid mantle of the Earth, there's also convection going on deep below us on the planet, where the magma is moving through convection, and at points of volcanoes comes out of the Earth's crust. Now here we're flying over an ocean, and epoconvection is actually a small-scale version of the water that is flowing in the world's oceans. And near the poles of the Earth, the water cools down, and the remaining colder and heavier water then sinks and flows across the bottom of the oceans all the way to the Pacific on the other side of the world. So salinity also affects convection. Salty water is denser than fresh water, and therefore the salinity is also affected by gravity. Here we're going over East Africa, and here is an interesting phenomenon as well, because here you have a lot of volcanoes, for example the Ngorongoro crater and Mount Kilimanjaro, which is visible over there behind the Soyuz. And volcanoes are also in the something that has to do with convection, even of the liquid mantle of the Earth. Also there, convection takes place, and the fluid magma comes up. So I hope you like this lesson. It's very interesting to be here. It's fun. Weight is important for a lot of processes, and if you don't have it, things are very different, as you could see here. Okay, I hope your experiment. I hope you liked your experiment on ground, and you liked how we did it in space. I would say, auf Wiedersehen, au revoir, tot ziens, adios.